Am I audible to everyone? Let us start our discussion because still 50% of the students need to join. Already it is 2-2. Right, okay. Let us start our today's discussion. In the last class, we have started discussing how to develop the solution for an application using MapReduce programming model. Right? So, in the last class, we have discussed the mapper code as well as the reducer code, and little bit we have covered the functionalities of the partitioners, the job of the partitioner, and as well as combiner, right? So now let us discuss the driver code and how it is essential for running the MapReduce program. And then we will see some other examples of similar kind to better understand the necessity of mapper logics, reducer logics, and driver logics, so that you'll gain the knowledge and you are able to write the programs using these three codes. Now, my screen is visible to everyone. Is it visible to you? My screen is visible to you. Okay. Right. So in the last class, we have discussed the example of word count problem. For that, we have considered the four lines of text as an input to the mapper logic. And as you all aware of that, mapper logic will accept the information in the form of key value pairs only. So, whatever the format here, our input format is a text format. So, we need to convert our the text format into key value pairs. So, in order to convert your text input into key value pairs, we need to take the help from the record reader. What it does is it reads the information from the input file and it will be converted into key value pairs, so that mapper logic is going to use the key value pairs. So for that, the record reader is useful for you for converting text into key value pairs like this. Okay, so whatever the key value pairs that are created by the record reader, those will be supplied to the mapper function. I'll show you the functionality of record reader. So this is the syntax for the record reader. It's a public interface record reader, KV. Okay, so what it contains is create key, create value. Okay, create an object of the appropriate type to be used by as a key. Create an object of the appropriate type to be used as value. So these are the methods that are available along with the record reader class. Okay, interface, sorry. And so simply it converts the byte oriented view of the input provided by the input strip and present as a record oriented view of for the mapper and reducer logics for the processing. Similarly, record writer also, it converts the key value pairs of data into byte oriented format. In our case, it is going to be converted into text data. So that is the final step actually, right? Now, so in the mapper phase, what we have to do is whatever the input split that it was supplied for this mapper logic, what it does is simply it reads this entire line and it captures or extracts word by word, and finally it produces the intermediary output like a word followed by the value. What one, do one, you one, mean one, buy one, object one. Like that it produces the output. Similarly, all other mappers are also be produced the same output in the same fashion, right? Here we have discussed the importance of combiner. By using that combiner, we can group the intermediary key value pairs that are produced from the mapper logic will be summarized, grouped based on the key. Whatever the values that are associated for that key, all the values are grouped together, right? And that will be supplied to the reducer function. Combiner is a semi-reducer, which is also called as semi-reducer, which performs the certain operations that are performed by the reducer. There is no specific class for it. It need to use the reducer class as its base class, right? And with the help of the combiner function, we are able to save the bandwidth of the network by reducing too many interactions between mapper logic and reducer logic, right? And in the reducer phase, what we did is simply we'll consolidate or we'll finalize the desired outputs in such a way you are supposed to write the logic. So that is about mapper code and the reducer code. Now let us see the driver code. As I told you, the main function, whatever the code that you are supposed to be written in the main program itself will be considered as driver code. So first we need to create a configuration object. As I told you in the previous case, classic MapReduce framework, we need to create separate configuration objects for the job and as well as other configurations. But here you need not create in such a way. Simply with the configuration object itself, it will take care of all the processes, right? So a job dot job get instance of word count. Here our program, whatever the program name is here itself, that will be specified here itself. And jar class, whatever the jar class that we have created, jar file that we have created for this particular program. Okay. And whatever the class name where you can store all these things, you need to specify that class name. And set mapper class, set combiner class, set reducer class. Here you can observe that we are supposed to use the reducer class name for the combiner class also, because there is no specific format for it. Similarly, set output key class. What is the type of the output and output value? This is for key and this is for value, right? So in this case, what is the output that we are expecting? A word. And what is the value that it need to have? How many number of times it was repeated? So here the key is text and the value is integer variable, integer value. And input format, okay, whatever the path that you have specified by supplying arguments from the command line itself, it will be similarly output path. As you know that while defining these two, you must be very careful, because if you are not specifying this path properly, what it does is it is unable to perform the splitting process and all. So for that reason, simply without executing, just it stops the job execution and it responds with an error message if you are not specifying the input path in a proper way, because it is unable to construct the input splits. Similarly, output path, if you are not specifying, or if you specify already existing output path, what happens in that case is in that case also it raises an error message, because it assumes that it may be whatever the path that you have specified, which is already existing, what it assumes is it was created by some other application. So some other application is trying to store the outputs into that. So in such a way, it assumes and it produces the error messages if you specify the path which is already existing one as your output path, right? So these are the essential things. Here what we did is we need to specify the jar files class, mapper class, reducer class, input path, output key data type, output value data type. Suppose if we use combiner, we need to specify the combiner class. So these all things, okay, these all things are essential for running any program, any MapReduce program. Okay, so you might have observed the same kind of syntax in all the programs which we are going to be discussing, because these are essential. Without having this, your program may not be running automatically. Okay, so that is the reason one job should be configured with all these values, right? So this is the output which we can display after executing this program. Now let us see another example. Now hope you are all clear with what is the necessity of mapper code, what is the necessity of reducer code, and what is the necessity of driver code, because these two should be clear, then only you are able to understand other problems also. If you are not clear, I will once again explain. You please respond in the chat box if you are not clear with this. If anybody is not clear with this importance of these three types of codes, once again we will discuss, no issue. But it is very essential for us for understanding upcoming examples and upcoming concepts also. Anybody is having any queries? Anybody is having any query? No queries? Okay. Then I can understand you all are clear with this importance of mapper code, reducer code, and driver code. Now let us see another example. Here you can observe the table. These are the this is the electrical consumption of an organization. It contains the monthly electrical consumption and the annual average for various years. For example, this is the electrical consumption of an organization. In the year 1979, it consumes 23 words in the month of January, like February. At last column represents the average of all these recordings, right? Similarly, different years information is available. Okay, so that is the input which is available for us. So what we have, organization in the year, organization, how much electric power it consumed in the month. So we have the information regarding all the months consumption and as well as average for that year of an organization. So what is similarly, there are n number of organizations are there in a state. Okay, similarly you can take, if you observe in our Andhra Pradesh, right, there are so many organizations. For every organization, they will consume certain amount of power on every month, right? Now if what we can do with this, what kind of analysis we can do with this data is, so you can read this statement. If the above data is given as input, we have to write applications to process it and produce results such as finding the year of maximum usage. Finding the year of maximum usage and year of minimum usage and so on. Okay. And now, if you have a finite number of, if you have 100 records or 200 records, you can easily develop the logic and you can write in any other programming languages. But here, keep it in your brain, like there are n number of organizations are there. For each and every organization, they'll consume certain amount of power in every month. Like that, calculating the maximum usage in an year. Similarly, generally in the summer, we might have observed some of the statistics that are released by the power distribution companies. So in the previous year, this much of workload is there, this much of units are consumed in this month, but now it was increased. Like that, you might have heard about certain news in the newspapers regarding the statistics, how they will be calculated. Okay, so that means how they will be calculate the total amount of congestion in a year or in a month. Because there is no single organization or single home is present in the state itself, right? There are so many. How it is going to be calculated? So these things we will see now itself. Okay. When you write application for to process the bulk data, will take a lot of time to execute. Okay. To solve these problems, we'll use the MapReduce. So now let us see. Here, the data is the input. The whole information will be placed in a file called input.txt. What it contains is year followed by the month's information, and last column itself is average, right? Now for this program, how do we implement using MapReduce logic itself is, so first we will look it out mapper logic, how it will be implemented. So here, what is the data types of key value pairs? Because here we need to specify the key value pair data types. So here you can observe that long writable, it is input key type, and text, it is input value type. For outputs also, text and int writable. Okay, don't worry about it. So here we want to find out the maximum consumption that was recorded in an year, right? So for that, what we have to do? So you know, if somebody is, just please tell me what exactly the map methods, the parameters of the map method. D7, D7, F9, are you there? Mohan Babu sir. Sir, you please record the numbers, those who are not responding to my calls. Because they are logically present, but not physically present here. Okay? You just note down the numbers and we mark it as an absent. At least if they are unable to respond through the mic, they are supposed to respond in the chat box itself. But they did not do anything. So what it seems... Sorry, sir. You are not audible.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Yeah, now you can mute yourself. B9. If you are unable to unmute yourself, you can respond in the chat box. B9, you can unmute yourself. Are you able to unmute or not?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Now, you just tell me what are the importance of these four parameters. Now I will highlight whatever I require. Okay. You just observe the words in the highlighted area and you just tell me what is it. Are you able to see the screen or not?
Yes, sir.
Yeah. So the first one is long writable key, comma, text value, and followed by output collector. It is also two parameters, text comma, int writable. What is the meaning of, or what exactly these words? Sorry? You know or you don't know? B9. Yeah, tell me. You know or you don't know? Sorry? Respond quickly. You know or you don't know it? Your voice is not clear.
signal problem.
Data? You just typed some message in the chat box, like whether you know it or you don't know. Make it fast. H4. H4. B7. B7. Okay. Some other kind of treatment, because we don't want to waste much more time. Yeah, so here, this is the long writable key, is the data type for the input key, and this is for the data type for input value. That means here, long writable is same as long data type in Java. So the input key value type is long, and our value type is text. So output collector is used to collect the outputs that are produced by the mapper logic, because here we are using in the map method. So that's why by using this output collector, we can collect the outputs that are produced by this map method. Okay, and this reporter, by using this reporter object, we can know the progress and the status of the execution of our job. Right, now we will extract the first line of information using value dot to string. Our string tokenizer s is equals to new string tokenizer of line comma tabular one. Now we will read one by one. String here is equals to s dot next token. Initially it is at beginning of the line, so whatever the next element, that will be stored into the year. Now what it contains, year contains this particular one, right? Now what we are supposed to, how do we know the maximum? By using the last column value, right? How do we move to the last column? We'll see. So while S has more tokens, what S? It points the line. What is line? Whatever the input that you have extracted. Okay, I has more tokens. Last token is equals to, initially it was null, last token is equals to S dot next token. We'll repeat the loop until we will reach this position. Once we reach this position, what is there, any has next or has more tokens? No, because this is the last, right? So whenever, if it reaches the last location, whatever the value that it was captured, that will be stored in the last location. Now int average price is equals to integer dot parse int of last token. What it contains? Last token, the last value in the first line. The last value in the first line. I mean, whatever the line that it was considered as an input. So whatever the last value which is present in that line, that will be assigned to last token. Last token. So the same will be assigned to average price. So here we'll apply the conversion mechanism. Then output dot collect. What we are supposed to be here, we'll calculate from each line, we'll extract the year, and we need to be extract the average consumption. Like that, we need to capture all the year's averages from that list. From that list, we'll try to find out the maximum so that we can produce the result like on which year the maximum consumption has recorded. This is for a particular organization. If you want to do it for the n number of organizations, just nothing will be there. You just add all those data to your input.txt file, whatever it may be, the number of records that you have. Okay, for all the things, the process will be the same. Right. So now, how, as I told you, output collector. In the output collector interface, we have a method called collect. What it does is it collects the outputs that are produced by this particular method. Okay. Here, what we are, so you need to write the intermediate result as year. What is this? S dot next token. That means whatever the first record that you have considered for this process, whatever the first value, that is first value in that record is year. So that was stored in the year itself. So the same, and as well as new iteratable of average price. What is average price? The last token which we have assigned. What is last token? This last token contains the last value of that line, that is 25. So from this, suppose if you supply this particular line as an input to this MapReduce function, find the output from this is 1979 as a key value, key and value as 25. This information will be printed as an output. Okay. Similarly, for this 1980, the average value is 29. Like that, it will be all the mapper logics will produce the outputs. Okay. Is it clear to everybody? Right now, what we have to do? We'll write the reducer class for this. What reducer class has to do? What are the inputs that are available to the reducer class? So the inputs contains year followed by the consumption, average consumption, right? So from this, you need to find out the maximum consumed in an year. We are supposed to be find out. So for that, what way we are supposed to develop our reducer logic is, so here reduce method, text key, iterator, values, because when you are talking about multiple organizations, okay, each and every organization will have the information like this. So that is the reason here is always it is single one, and the values are multiple. So that is the reason here we are using iterator. Iterator is used to extract values one by one from the list. Output collector, text comma in, because finally we need to display year followed by the maximum consumption or average consumption. And reporter, using this you can, because in the mapper logic we did not write even single statement using this reporter, because here we don't want to know the progress of our job execution. Whenever if you want to use it, you can use it, no issue. Right now, let us see the logic. While values dot has next, what is val? Initially, val is assigned with minimum value. Values are the list of values that are associated to an year. Okay, that are associated to an year. So here the values is a collection of elements. From this, we'll read one by one. Values dot has next. Suppose if it is having next value, then only this loop will be entered into the execution. Otherwise, simply terminates. If val is equals to value dot next, initially we'll extract that first value and it will be placed into the variable val. If it is greater than maximum average, here we have defined the maximum average as 30. Suppose whatever the value that you have extracted from this list is greater than maximum average, what it indicates? Yes, that is the maximum value now, right? So what we have to do? We need to write the year and whatever the value which is greater than this maximum value, right? Is it clear to everybody or not? Like that, we'll repeat the process till we find out the which year the maximum consumption is recorded. Now, let us see the main function. In this is driver code. So job configuration, object conf is equals to new job configuration of process unit class, configuration dot set job name, set output key class, set output value class, set mapper class. Mapper class means whatever the class name that you have created in the mapper logic. Here e underscore em mapper is the name of the mapper class. Similarly, e underscore e reduce is the class name for reducer class, the same which we have mentioned here itself. Combiner class, for combining also we'll use the same, because there is no specific class for the combiner class. Okay. Input format, output format, set input path, output path. So you can see all these, whatever the statements that we have discussed in the previous example, and now also the same. Did you observe it or not? In the previous exam, word count example also, we wrote the statements in the same pattern. Only these class names are varied from one program to another program. So these are all essentials for every program. So that's why with the help of these only, this program execution will be done. So that's why we are call it as a driver code. So when you run the program, you might have see the output like this. How many reduce tasks are executed, how many local map tasks are executed in program, slots, it all information will be displayed, and finally this is the output that it was displayed. Some part information of output which I want to display, so that's why it was displayed as this is the years on which the maximum temperature has recorded, right? Now, so that is about mapper logic, reducer logic, driver code and all. And in the last class, I was explained a little bit about partitioner. What is the job of this partitioner is, whenever if you have zero reducers, whatever the outputs that are produced by the mapper logic directly, they will be written into the output path which you have specified in your driver code. When it will be? Whenever if you are not specifying any reducer class, right? If you specify only one reducer class, what happens? All the outputs of the mapper logics will be supplied as an input to the reducer logic if you have only one reducer task. But when you have multiple reducers, more than one, in that case, what you are supposed to be done is all the outputs of the mapper logics will be split into groups. How many groups we are supposed to split? It depends upon the number of reducer tasks that you are supposed to execute. Suppose in my case, I am going to define two reducer tasks. Okay, two reducer tasks in the sense you need not write two times the code. As we have discussed in the previous class, how many maps are defined, how many reducers are defined. Okay, so you need not write two times the same code. It means that two reducer functions are executed in two different systems. What happens in that case? They will share the workload so that the execution time will be reduced. Otherwise, if you supply the whole data to the single reducer, what happens in that case? It takes more amount of time when you are executing the same with the two reducer tasks. So in such a way, we will parallelize the execution process. In such a way, we'll improve the performance of our system. That is the importance of increasing it. So how much? So can we increase it to the 10 and 100? There also, it becomes a overload on you to manage the things. So that's why how many reducers are to be there, how many maps are to be there, they're clearly specified. For the maps, it should be based on the size of input blocks and all. Whereas for the, I think this concept which I was discussed in the previous class, otherwise I'll show you once again, no issue. It is there in this document. I'll show you the formula. Yes, this. How many reducers? So the right number of reducers seems to be 0.95 or 1.7. No issue, that is not an issue. So here you can observe this formula. Number of nodes into map red dot task tracker dot reduce dot task dot maximum. Right? So you just multiplied with this 0.95 or 1.75, whatever the value that you acquired, that you obtained, that will be the maximum number of reducers that you are supposed to be defined. So here with 0.95, all of the reducers can launch immediately and start transferring map outputs as the map finish. With 1.75, the faster nodes will finish their first round of the reduce and launch the second wave of the reduce. Okay, so this is some information regarding this. You just remember this formula so that you can calculate how many number of reducers are required for your, for the execution of your process. Okay, and now in this case, what you are supposed to understand is the partitioner simply it splits the, or it separates, or it divides the total output that was produced by the mapper logics into number of groups. Number of groups, how many number of groups? Whatever the number of reduced tasks that are executed. Suppose if in your program two reduced tasks are executed, okay, so you need to be split into two partitions. So the mapper logic outputs are supposed to be split into two groups, okay, or two partitions simply. So that is the job of partitioner. So in such a way, you can define the partitioners also, right? So we will see another example for the implementation of a partition also, right? The partitioner works like a condition in a processing and input data set. The partition phase takes place after the map phase and before the reduce phase. Even I can show you the sequence of steps to be followed while executing this map reduce codes also. Just a minute. Yeah. This is the execution of the components, that is mapper, combiner, and partitioner. Mapper, the input data is initially processed by all the mappers, map jobs, and then intermediary outputs is created. That is the job of the mapper logic. What next? Combiner logic will be executed. What it does, all intermediate outputs are optimized by local aggregation before the shuffle or short phase by the combiner. So the primary goal of combiner is to save as much bandwidth as possible by minimizing the number of key value pairs that will be shuffled across the network and provided as an input to the reducer. Just simply it groups the values based on key, and the same will be supplied as an input to the reducer function. And next, partitioner. Once the combiner has generated consolidated input for the reducer logic, so now partitioner comes into the picture. So what it does is, depends upon the number of reducers, the output produced by the combiner logic will be split it into number of partitions. If you are in your application, two reducers are executed, the combiner output will be split into two partitions. One partition will be supplied to one reducer and another partition will be supplied to the another reducer. So here you have a provision like user can control the flow. That means user can specify which partition will be assigned to which reducer. In such a way, you can have the facility to control it, right? So the default partition is hash partition, partitioner, which computes the hash value for the key and assign the partition based on this result. See how it will be split into parts is, it uses the hash partition process. So hash part, you know how a hashing will be done. Simply the value will be passed to the hash function. Hash function will produce the key value, right? So in such a way we'll do. And after completing the partitioning, each partition will be supplied to reducer logic, and reducer logic will finally produce the output. So this is the sequence of steps that are executed in the MapReduce program. Hope you all clear with this or not. So that is the job of the partitioner. So in the next class, we will see example programs on the partitioner, how it will be implemented, and how the outputs of the combiner is going to be split into blocks, and how those blocks are supplied as an input to the reducer, and what are the steps that we are supposed to be follow while partitioning the data. So these things which we can discuss in the next class, right? Is it clear to everybody? Or any queries? Are you able to understand what way we can write the mapper logics, what way we can write the reducer logics, combiners? Because these are very, very important building blocks of HDFS. There we studied about net anode, name node, job tracker, task tracker, secondary name node. In the similar way, for the map reduce programming, these four are essential: mapper code, reducer code, driver code, combiner code, and partitioner. These are the five important aspects that you are supposed to be understand. If you know all these things, you can easily develop the programs. Develop the programs in the sense, logic is your purely your interest, but remaining skeleton of the program, except logic, is same for all the programs. The same for all the programs. So that is the reason why we need to discuss number of examples to enrich your knowledge, right? Okay. So today's absentees are 98, B3, B5, B8, C6, C9, D0, E1, E7, G2, G4, H3, H5, I2, LE502. So these are the today's absentees. Right? So if you have any queries, you can ask. Otherwise, I'll end the session. No queries? Right, okay. So we will discuss how to implement the partitioner in the next class. Thank you.